let's settle in, each of us in our own space, right where we are, but also together collectively. And just as you begin to settle into your space and you close your eyes and your body starts to relax just a bit, let's just reflect for just a few seconds before we actually begin our practice. Just reflect how many people across this globe are doing exactly what we're doing in this moment. Maybe some already had their practice today. Maybe some will do it as they wake up when the new day comes tomorrow. But I believe that even here in this moment, there are others across this globe, within this humanity of which we are a part, there are other people seeking the same things that we seek. Maybe in a different language, with different cultural practices, traditions. Their home may look very different than ours, but we all want the same thing. We all want a little more peace and calm and ease and presence in our life. And I find that thought both exciting and incredibly comforting, which makes our goal of transforming the world seem a little more realistic. So with that thought, let's just each start to breathe nice and slow, calm and deep, and finding a little balance between the inhale and the exhale. And while we want the body to find some relaxation in our practice, we also want to stay somewhat alert with our spine growing long, whether you are lying down or you are seated. Just allow the spine just to stretch so that all the good prana, all the good chi, all the good energy can just flow in these moments that we have together. So collectively, let's take a breath in and let it go. Take a breath in and let it go. And one more together in and let it go. Before I center our thoughts together for these few minutes that we have, I would just encourage each of us, just scan your mind. See what is already busy and active in there, what thoughts are competing for your attention. Because the one thing that we don't try to do in meditation is we don't try to turn the mind off, but we do try to find some control over where we go with our thoughts. So just notice, what are the things lingering from today, maybe from 5 minutes before we came together? What are the things that are lingering from work, from family, from the responsibilities of your day? And don't think of them as good or bad or positive or negative. Just be aware of them. Just be aware. And as we settle in together with this idea of all these people across the planet having a meditation practice just like we are, I want to share with you a quote that I've really been returning to quite a bit this week. It's a quote that Ram Dass actually shared in one of his writings, but it's a quote by Einstein. And so I want to read it just a couple times to you. Just let it kind of sink in the first time. And then the second time, we'll begin to ponder exactly what meaning it has for each of us. So Albert Einstein said, "The true value of a human being can be found in the degree to which he's attained liberation from the self." So listen to that again. The true value of a human being can be found in the degree to which he has attained liberation from the self. And so I want to just kind of set our stage for these moments that we have, and maybe for the moments that will follow whenever we're finished and we leave each other's presence. I want to set the stage of this idea of liberation. And so I want to ask you just to think to yourself, what does liberation look like? And liberation meaning bigger than just freedom. Freedom, I know, especially in our country, it has its own ideas, and oftentimes, sadly, we kind of take it for granted, and it has a place in who we are as Americans. But think about the idea of liberation. there's this connotation that it comes from something that has held us down, something that has restrained us, held us back. And then all of a sudden, we become free from that thing. And then this idea of freedom takes on the fullness of liberation. So just picture it. What does it look like in your mind? When I think about liberation, I go back to some words that Viktor Frankl shared. He was one of the most quoted Holocaust survivors that we've had as a part of our history. And he talks about this idea of liberation even while he was a prisoner in a concentration camp. And he said, "I experienced liberation on a regular basis while I was there, because the one thing I still had was the control of my perspective, of the thoughts that I was having, and how I responded to what was happening around me." And so when I think about this idea of liberation, I see his face, and all of a sudden the meaning of that word just gets bigger. And if a person like Viktor Frankl and others like him can come to a place in their life and their experience where they have truly attained liberation from the self, meaning, I am not going to just let my thoughts dictate how I feel. I am not going to just let the circumstances around me change how I respond. And I am not going to be held captive by all the potential negativity and trauma and suffering that's around me. When I see liberation, I see that experience that he had. And so then I would ask each of us, once you picture what liberation is like, what are the things in your life that are holding you down or holding you back? Most of us in our experience, it's not as big or traumatic as what a person like Viktor Frankl experienced. But I will tell you, in our lives, those same things sometimes feel incredibly big. We have relationships with people. We have experiences from our past. We have really tough challenges in our health. We have a sense of loss of things and people that are no longer with us. And the list could go on and on for each of our experiences. They are all real. And they all have the potential, if we allow it, to hold us back. And so the idea is, so what are they holding us back from? And what Ram Dass tries to teach us by sharing this quote from Albert Einstein about this liberation from the self is he's trying to teach us that those things are holding us back from the present moment. They are all experiences that we have lived. They're all emotions that we have felt. And for some of us, they are circumstances that we are still having to confront in our life today. But I would ask you, which ones are the ones that are holding you back from experiencing the incredibleness of this present moment? And then as this moment passes, of you experiencing the incredibleness of the next, I don't want to discount or not honor the experiences that we have each had. They've all created the person that we've become today. But we each have a choice. And I think this quote from Einstein says it really clearly. We have a choice. Do all of our experiences, all of our interactions with people in the past as well as today, and tomorrow, are those things going to just help us know ourselves better? Or are they going to hold us down and hold us back? We have a choice. It's in our perspective. It's in how we see these interactions around us. And it's in how, little by little, breath by breath, we release the hold that these traumas have on us. And that is when we experience true liberation. It's a tall order, and it takes a while. But just like all these thousands and millions, I'd like to thank people across the globe having a meditation practice just like us. It's a sign that we want to understand the power of the present moment. We don't want to be held back. We don't want to be held down. And we may not yet know how, but we do know we want that picture of liberation that we've each just had in our mind. So let's just sit for these next couple of moments. Each of us in our space, each of us with our thing, our things. And just use these next couple of minutes, the quiet, the breath, the presence, to just secure your commitment that I'm not sure how, but I do know that I don't want these things to hold me back or hold me down anymore. I want to experience liberation from the self. And instead of feeling like I'm a prisoner or a victim and that life is just happening to me, I want to grab on to the choice and the control that I have. Just take a long, slow, deep breath in. Exhale, release it out. Another long, slow breath in. Exhale, release it out. And I want to close our time with just a couple affirmation statements that maybe will help to secure this commitment that we each have. So as you sit in your space and I sit in mine, maybe you say these words to yourself, you repeat them after me. Maybe you let my words just hold space for all of us. But I deserve liberation from the things that have held me back. I deserve liberation from the things that have held me back. And the second affirmation says, I choose to live in the present moment. I choose to live in the present moment. So I would encourage you, take those words with you, reminding yourself that you deserve to let these things go. You deserve liberation. And it will come with that second statement. I choose to live in the present moment. One breath, one moment at a time. Namaste.